Ladies and gentlemen, Emerson.
Johnson, it's your old tennis partner.
It's my buddy.
Played with him in Aspen, not.
The nominees for Best Performance by an Actress in a Motion Picture Musical or Comedy are Jamie Lee Curtis, A Fish Called Wanda.
Melanie Griffith, Working Girl.
Amy Irving, Crossing the Lancer.
Michelle Pfeiffer, Married to the Mob.
Susan Sarandon, Bull Durham. And the winner is... Melanie Griffith, Working
Girl. I didn't, the last time I was up here, I was Miss Golden Globes.
Thank 20th Century Fox and Leonard Goldberg and Barry Diller and Larry Marks and Doug Wick, the best producer ever. I mean, you actually want him on the set. And Kevin Wade, who wrote this incredible screenplay. And most of all, Mike Nichols, who changed my life. And thanks to all the working girls. Goodbye. Thanks. Well, so here we are to present the first award of the evening, which is, well, I guess it's not exactly an awesome responsibility, but it's a big deal. I mean, we don't want to look stupid or misread the cue cards or look like we've never seen each other before or anything like that, right?
Well, I think they know we've seen each other before, dear. Why don't you just take a couple of deep breaths and try and relax and pretend you're in Lamaze class or something.
No, I'll be fine. Let's just give the award, okay?
Yeah. It's particularly appropriate that the award is for the supporting actors because, well, let's face it, I have supported one or two actresses in the past.
Yeah, and one or two have supported you.
I I don't think anybody really wants to hear about that right now.
I do.
Dear? Well, I don't think...
Oh, I do. I want to know. I mean, what's the matter? Scared of a few billion people out there, honey?
Well, I'll tell you what. After the show, I'll take you out to the supermarket. We'll buy a few magazines, and you can read all about it. How I lived in a UFO for 6 years, how in a former life you were Anne Boleyn, and how our household pets have all gotten literary agents and are telling our secret story from the point of view of the foot of the bed. In the meantime, why don't we read the list of nominees?
Why don't we read that? The nominees for Best Performance by an Actress in a Supporting Role are my wonderfully talented colleagues. From Working Girl, Joan Cusack.
From The Accidental Tourist, Gina Davis.
From Mississippi Burning, Frances McDormand.
From Dangerous Liaisons, Michelle Pfeiffer.
And also from Working Girl, Sigourney Weaver.
And the Oscar goes to Gina
Davis,
The Accidental Tourist.
Tonight, live from the Shrine Auditorium in Los Angeles, California, the motion picture capital of the world, it's the 61st Annual Academy Awards. And moonlighting tonight, Bruce Willis and Demi Moore. Best Actor nominee, Edward James Olmos. And first-time nominee and best friends, Don Johnson and Melody Griffith.
Welcome to Miami. This is a city with moods and attitudes and a whole mixed bag of cultural influences. I'm Don Johnson, and I'm going to take you on a little helicopter tour of my old stomping grounds. You got ultra-modern hotels, the financial district, some of the most beautiful seascapes of any place in the world. I love this place. I think you will too. You know, I found a new race boat. I think it's big enough to take the water, but I can't figure out where to put the engines. What do you think of that, huh? Is this a great place or what? Yes, it was tough duty down here doing Miami Vice, but somebody had to do it. All these people going out to sea on some of the cruise ships and the gambling casinos. All right, let's go on over to South Beach. I want to show you one of my favorite spots in all the world. How'd I do that? I amaze myself sometimes. You see, now, this is South Beach. Right now, it's kind of laid back, a little casual. But I guarantee you, by sundown tonight, this place will be wall to wall. Miami is one of the most exotic places on earth. There's a place in my heart in this city that's pretty dang special. The tour is over, ladies and gentlemen. Let's go racing.
The Port of Miami presents the Grand Condominium's Offshore Powerboat Race of Miami. is the return of offshore powerboat racing to the East Coast and the Atlantic Ocean after two events off the coast of California. Space Age Technology, the top powerboat racers in fine-tuned machines, set to battle the elements and each other over 150 miles.
It's the 62nd Annual Academy Awards. Supporting actress nominee Julia Roberts. Those beautiful fresh flowers are all from Holland. Here's Don Johnson and his wife Lily Griffith, nominated last year for Best Actress.
There. Former world champion in 1988, he developed an appreciation for offshore racing while filming Miami Vice. He's got four 980 horsepower engines in that $1.2 million craft.
And he also has a 2-second lead over Charlie Marks in Eric's Reality, who's really pressing him now. Earlier today, Art Ekman had a chance to talk to Don Johnson.
What was intriguing about offshore racing, Don?
The worst part about it was that I won my first race. That's what ruined me. See, I could have walked away if I'd have lost. But I won, I love the competition, and I like motor sports and water sports, and having the two of them together is just got it all.
What was it like before that first race, when you know that you're racing against guys that have raced for several years, and did you get the respect immediately, or did they say this guy's an actor with a new toy?
No, they wouldn't talk to me for the first year and a half. I just showed up and kept doing my thing and racing just like any of the other racers. In 88, I was lucky enough to win the world championship. After that, they pretty much accepted me as one of their own and fairly real. And
something to be dealt with.
Yeah, someone to be dealt with, yeah.
What about your crew now and the people you've assembled for Team USA?
Well, I've been very lucky in that. I've got my boat builder, John Sadowski, is also my navigator, so he's... When he's out there with us, he's also constantly analyzing and checking and double-checking the performance of the boat. He's a wonderful navigator, too. And aside from that, I got the best throttle man in the business, Richie Powers. RP, we call him. There's nobody better. He's the guy that you want to put your life in his hands when you're out there doing a buck 30.
New technology is always challenging. It means a lot of adjustments throughout the season.
Oh, we're always tweaking and turning and trying to find the best way to make the boat more stable and to get more power out of the engines and yet not hurt them. And we've done a lot of work on the boat this year. We've put some tabs in the tunnel that help keep the nose down, and when we get in rough water and when you get up in those top speeds, you want to kind of have as much control over the boat as you possibly can. So we've done some modifications to the boat to help us do that.
Let's pick up the action now, the superboats. We still have a tremendous challenge between Team USA and Eric's Reality as they head for the Golden Gate. Jim, they don't look like they're having many problems with the rough water under the gate.
No, it does not seem that. And look at here. It's going to be a side-by-side battle as they go under that scenic bridge. And on the top of your screen, it is Don Johnson and his boat, Team USA, and Eric's Reality with a slight edge, and that is Charlie Marks, as they now come to the next checkpoint. They'll be making a left turn here shortly.
Charlie Marks, of course, president of the Automated Datatron, a data processing company. Also, he's head of systems products that employs high school students, paving the way for college tuitions.
Now the lead is going to change hands as Don Johnson comes up in Team USA. He has four 980 horsepower engines, while Eric's Reality, now dropping back to second, has four Gentry Turbo Eagle engines at 900 horsepower each.
Jim, that's a combined total of 7,520 horsepower with those two boats. Don Johnson's wife, Melanie Griffith.
Melanie, when your husband's out there racing, do you worry at all?
Yeah, sure I worry, but I just pray to God and support him a lot and try and enjoy it.
Actually, an entertainment career is a lot like this. It's always competitive.
Yeah, well, I guess so.
But you look a little worried today. I think he's going to be all right.
I do?
Yeah.
I'm really not. He's really good at what he does, and he really enjoys this. And
And so the kids and I are here to watch him and have a good time.
You support him?
Mm-hmm, absolutely.
Don Johnson, along with navigator Kurt Russell, will man this boat tomorrow. And Don was ready for my challenge.
I can make mincemeat out of this guy. This is easy.
Oh, yeah? Come on out tomorrow, buddy. We love new meat like you.